Nestled deep within the dense, mystical expanse of the Kokorinsko Forest lies a castle, an enigmatic fortress with a purpose unlike any other. Built not to defend those within its walls, but rather to shield the outside world from something far more sinister within. Hey everyone, welcome back to our channel. In today's episode, we are diving into the eerie and fascinating world of Houska Castle. Now, the Czech Republic is home to an array of stunning castles such as Prague Castle, Český Krumlov Castle, and Karlštejn Castle. However, Houska Castle stands apart from these architectural marvels for a rather spine-chilling reason. Locals and travelers alike say that in this place, the air is thick with secrets and the walls whisper of ancient horrors. So brace yourself for a journey into the unknown as we uncover the terrifying secrets of Houska Castle. Houska Castle, built in the 13th century during the reign of Otakar II of Bohemia. Unlike most castles, Houska Castle was erected in an area devoid of any strategic value. No major trade routes pass through this region, and there are no nearby rivers or water sources. It's almost as if the castle was deliberately isolated, built not to protect its inhabitants from external threats, but perhaps to guard against something else entirely. The Kokorinsko Forest surrounding Houska Castle is steeped in mystery. Locals speak of strange creatures and apparitions that roam the woods. Hunters and hikers have reported seeing spectral figures and hearing unearthly sounds at night. The forest's dense canopy and twisted paths seem to hide secrets waiting to be uncovered. One of the most unsettling aspects of Houska Castle is the courtyard, where dead bears are frequently found. Visitors often report discovering lifeless bears scattered across the grounds, as if struck down mid-flight by the castle's malevolent energy. Moving deeper into the castle, we encounter an area of Gothic statues. These sculptures, carved with meticulous detail, are scattered throughout the halls and rooms. One statue that stands out is that of a hooded monk, said to represent one of the castle's many ghostly apparitions. The somber expression on the monk's face and the intricate folds of his robe showcase the skill of the medieval craftsman who created him. In the Grand Knight's Hall, we find a collection of statues depicting knights in armor. These statues are not just decorative, they serve as silent guardians of the castle's rich history. Each knight's armor is unique, reflecting the heraldic symbols of various noble families who once sought refuge within these walls. Standing in their presence, you can almost hear the clinking of armor and the harsh conversations of knights preparing for battle. One such statue is that of a mythical creature, part human, part beast, which stands in a secluded corner of the courtyard. Local legends suggest it guards the castle against the dark forces rumored to lurk in the area. The creature's menacing expression and twisted form add to the castle's eerie atmosphere, leaving visitors to wonder about the stories behind its creation. Local legends tell a far more chilling story. They say that Houska Castle was constructed over a deep pit, a gateway to hell itself, to seal the demonic creatures that lurked below. To keep the evil contained, a chapel was built directly over the pit, dedicated to Archangel Michael, the vanquisher of evil. In the chapel, you can see images of Saint Michael slaying dragons and other demonic beings. These artworks serve not only as religious symbols, but also as reminders of the castle's dark purpose. One particularly eerie mural shows a left-handed center shooting a human figure, a rare and symbolic image in Christian art, suggesting themes of heresy and the supernatural. In an effort to understand and perhaps close the portal to hell, the local authorities decided to conduct an experiment. They sought volunteers from the local prison, offering a pardon to any inmate who would agree to be lowered into the pit to investigate its depths. One young prisoner, whose name has been lost to history, stepped forward, desperate for freedom and likely skeptical of the supernatural claims. He agreed to the perilous task. The authorities and the curious onlookers gathered around the edge of the chasm as preparations were made to lower the prisoner into the abyss. The prisoner was tied with a sturdy rope and slowly lowered into the dark, foreboding pit. Initially, the descent was uneventful, with only the sounds of the rope creaking and the echoing drops of water breaking the silence. However, as the descent further, the atmosphere grew colder and more oppressive. The witnesses above waited in tense silence. Suddenly, the calm was shattered by the prisoner's blood-curdling screams. His cries of terror echoed from the depths, sending chills down the spines of those above. The men quickly began to haul the rope back up, desperate to retrieve the prisoner and understand what had caused such immediate and intense fear. When the prisoner was finally pulled to the surface, a collective gasp rose from the crowd. The young man who had been lowered into the pit was unrecognizable. His hair, which had been dark and youthful, was now completely white. His face was twisted in an expression of sheer horror, eyes wide and staring as if witnessing something beyond human comprehension. He had aged dramatically in the few minutes he had been out of sight. The prisoner was incoherent, babbling about horrific creatures and visions of hell that he had witnessed in the darkness. He spoke of grotesque beings clawing at him, the overwhelming stench of sulfur, and whispers of malevolent voices promising eternal torment. The young prisoner was never the same. He was taken away, his mind shattered by the experience. Some versions of the legend say he died shortly afterward, unable to cope with the trauma. Others claim he lived out his days in a state of madness, constantly haunted by the visions from the pit. During World War II, the Nazis occupied Czechoslovakia and were notorious for their interest in occultism and supernatural phenomena. Hitler and his inner circle were obsessed with ancient artifacts and sites believed to possess otherworldly powers. Houska Castle, with its eerie legends and isolated location, drew the attention of the Third Reich. In 1939, shortly after the invasion of Czechoslovakia, Hitler dispatched a team of SS officers to Houska Castle under the command of General Hermann Frank, a high-ranking Sudeten German Nazi official. Frank was known for his ruthless methods and deep involvement in Nazi operations in the occupied territories. The true purpose of the Nazi occupation of Houska Castle remains shrouded in mystery, but several theories have emerged over the years. Some believe that the castle was used for secret SS experiments, including attempts to harness supernatural forces to gain an advantage in the war. Others suggest that the Nazis conducted gruesome medical experiments on prisoners within the castle's walls, trying to unlock the secrets of life and death. There are also accounts of the Nazis searching for the legendary bottomless pit, hoping to exploit its supposed connection to other realms. Witnesses reported seeing strange lights and hearing unearthly sounds emanating from the castle during this time, further fueling the rumors of occult practices. As the war drew to a close and the Allies advanced, the Nazis abandoned Houska Castle, leaving behind a trail of unanswered questions and eerie silence. Local legends claim that the spirits of those who suffered at the hands of the Nazis still haunt the castle, adding to its already formidable reputation. The locals are full of stories about Houska Castle. Some say that strange experiments were conducted within its walls during World War II when the Nazis occupied the castle. Others claim that the castle is still haunted by the spirits of those who perished in the pit or were victims of the castle's sinister past. Thank you for joining me on this journey into the dark history of Houska Castle. If you enjoyed this video, don't forget to like, subscribe and hit the bell icon for more intriguing stories from the past. Share your thoughts in the comments below. What do you think about Houska Castle? Until next time, stay curious and stay safe.